Good morning, everyone. Let us start this session. So during the last lecture, we were discussing about the curvilinear motion, and we have solved the problems on the rectangular component of the curvilinear motion. So this was the last problem that was given as a homework. So we will complete this problem, and then we will start with the normal and tangent component of the curvilinear motion. So if you refer this problem, a particle performs the curvilinear motion, has velocity components, Vx is 32t minus 4, and Vy, this is equal to 4 meter per second, okay? That means its y component is constant and x component is varying with this equation. 32t minus 4. Okay. At t is equal to 3 second, the particle is at the position 5, 12 meter. Okay. So suppose the particle performs the curvilinear motion in the xy plane. So this is the path which is traced by the particle. Okay. At any instant of time, so here t is equal to 3 seconds. At this time, particle position is represented by P, and it is having the coordinates 5 and 12. Okay. So what is meaning of 5 and 12? 5 represent the x coordinate and 12, it represent the y coordinate. Okay. So we have to find out the equation of the path traced by the particle. That means we have to find out the equation of this path. So this equation will be in the form of y is equal to f of x. Okay. So it may be a parabola. So it may have the equation like this, y square plus some constant c1 into y plus c2. Okay. We don't know what is the equation, but it may have the format like this. Okay. So we have to find out this equation of y as a function of x. So from these two equations, we will try to find out the equation for x and y, okay, as a function of time. So what is meaning of Vx? So Vx is nothing but the x component of velocity. Okay, so we can write this Vx in terms of x. So Vx is nothing but dx by dt. Okay, and similarly, Vy is the y component. So we can write this Vy, this is dy by dt. Okay, because the position vector r bar, if you refer the standard formula, then it is xi plus yj, okay, in the xy plane only. Then V bar is equal to vxi plus vyj, and A bar is equal to axi plus ayj. Okay. So you will get V bar if you differentiate the position vector r bar. So it is dr upon dt. It is nothing but the V bar. So Vx is nothing but dx by dt, and Vy is nothing but the dy by dt. Okay. Similarly, if you want the A bar, so it will become dv by dt. So ax is nothing but dvx upon dt. And Ay is nothing but dVy upon dt. Okay. So we can write Vx is equal to dx by dt. So equation is given for Vx. It is 32t minus 4. Okay. And for Vy, which is nothing but dy by dt, its equation is just 4. Okay, so from this equation, we can write dx is equal to 32t minus 4 into dt. Okay, and then you can integrate this equation to get the equation for x. So integrate both the sides. So you will get x is equal to integrate this 32t, so it will become 16t square minus 4t plus constant of integration, as we are not using any limit for the integration. Okay, and similarly integrate this equation, so it will dy is equal to 4dt. Integrate both the sides, so you will get y is equal to, this is 4t square by 2, sorry, 4t plus constant of integration, so it is c2. Okay, so now use the given condition. So what is the given condition? At t is equal to 3 second, position of the particle is 5 and 12. That means at t is equal to 3, x is equal to 5 and y it is equal to 12 meter. Okay, so use this condition to get the value of c1 and use this condition to get the value of c2. Okay, so x is equal to, it is 16t square minus 4t plus constant c1, and condition is t is equal to 3, x is equal to 5 meter. So you can put this value in this equation. So x is 5, this is 16, 3 square minus 4 into 3 plus c1. Okay, so try to simplify this equation. So you will get the value of c1. Then refer the second equation, that is for the y. So y is equal to 4t plus c2. And the condition is t is equal to 3, y is equal to 12. So put the value y 12, that is 4 into 3 plus c2. So c2 is equal to 0. Okay, so what is the value of c1? So c1 value, this is minus 127 and c2 is 0. So put this equation, put this constant c1 in this equation. So finally we will get x is equal to 16t square minus 4t minus 127. So this is equation 1, and put the value of c2 in the equation of y. So y is equal to 4t. So this is your second equation. Okay, so finally we want the equation for y, which will be function of x, or x which is function of y. So from this equation you can put the value of t, which is equal to y by 4, and put this value in the equation 1. So you will get the value x is equal to 16, this is y by 4 square minus 4 into y by 4 minus 127. So x is equal to, this is 16, y square by 16 minus, you can cancel out this 4, minus 127. So finally you will get the equation x is equal to y square minus y minus 127. Okay, so this is the equation for the path traced by that particle in the xy plane. So basically this equation is nothing but x is equal to f of y, and this is a parabola. Okay, so I hope this problem is clear. Okay, so now we will solve the problem on the normal and tangent component for the curvilinear motion. So in the last lecture we have seen how we can divide the components in the normal and tangent direction. So suppose a particle, it performs the curvilinear motion in the xy plane, So at particular instant, particle is at the point P, having some coordinates x and y. And this is the velocity, which is tangent to the curve. So it represents the resultant vector v bar. So in the curvilinear motion, velocity is always tangential to the path. So if you want to find out acceleration in the tangent and normal direction, then the component of acceleration, which is along this v bar, this is called as tangent component. So it is represented as at. And the component which is perpendicular to at, this is called as normal component. So it is an. Okay. So resultant of these two vector. So this is the resultant vector for the acceleration, that is a bar. Okay. So this a, that is a resultant acceleration, this is calculated. So basically this is the magnitude for a bar. So it is an square plus at square. Okay. So at, this acceleration, we can find out by using the equations of motion. Okay. And the normal component of acceleration, its formula is v square upon the radius of the curve path. Okay. So now refer this problem. So in this problem, a particle moves along a circular path having the radius 4 meters. Calculate 4 seconds later the particle's total acceleration and the distance traveled if the first condition is speed is constant. So when the speed is constant, its tangential acceleration, this value is 0. Okay. And second, if the speed is 2 meters per second at an instant and it is increasing at the rate 0.7 meters per second square. Okay. So refer the first case where the speed is constant. So v, this is constant. That means its tangential component of acceleration, this is 0. Okay. So what is meaning of tangential component of acceleration? The component of acceleration which is along the vector v bar. As v is constant, this will be 0. Okay. But if the v is constant, it doesn't mean that normal component of acceleration is 0. Okay. It will have some normal component. It depends on the velocity and the radius. So we have to find out normal component. So an is equal to v square upon rho. So v, so it is given as, so speed is constant, it is having the value 2 meters per second. So this is this constant speed. So we can put the value 2. So this is 2 square upon rho is, this is the radius, so it is 4 meters. So it is 1 meter per second square. So tangential component is 0 and normal component of acceleration, this is equal to 1 meter per second square. So resultant acceleration, so a is equal to, this is an square plus at square. So this is equal to an is 1 plus 0. So your final answer will be 1 meter per second square. Okay. Now next is we have to find out total acceleration and the distance traveled. So we have to find out distance traveled. So how you can find out distance traveled? So for that we have to use the equation of motion. So we have to find out the distance traveled after 4 seconds. Okay. So here t is equal to 4 seconds. So you can use the equation s is equal to ut plus half a t square. Okay. And here this a is nothing but the tangential component. So it is a suffix t. And for the first case, speed is constant, so at is zero. So this total term will be zero. So your s value, it is nothing but velocity into time. Okay. So we can find out s is equal to velocity is constant, that is the 2 meter per second, into time is 4 seconds. So s is equal to 8 meter. Okay. So this is the answer for distance and the acceleration when the speed is constant. Now refer the second condition. Speed is 2 meter per second at an instant, and it is increasing at this rate, 0.7 meter per second square. So at particular instant, the speed of that particle, so at this point, this is equal to 2 meter per second, okay, and it is continuously increasing along this path, and it is having the acceleration. So the tangential component of acceleration, that is at, this is equal to 0.7 meter per second square, okay. And we have to find out the total acceleration. After 4 seconds. So to find out total acceleration, we will need the tangential component. After 4 seconds and normal component of acceleration after 4 seconds. Okay. So suppose the particle is at the point P1, when we measure this speed as 2 meter per second, okay, after 4 seconds, it occupies the position P2. So particle is here at the position P2. So to find out normal component, tangential component will remain constant, okay, after 4 seconds and before 4 seconds. So it will remain as a 0.7 meter per second square. This normal component, it depends on the velocity and its radius. Okay, so radius is given, which is equal to 4 meter. So we have to find out the velocity after 4 seconds. Okay, so take this value as a v2, and this is the v1, or we can take this value as the initial velocity u. Okay, so from point 1 to 2, use the equation of motion to find out the velocity at point 2. So we will consider the motion 1 to 2. So initial velocity, this is equal to 2 meter per second. Then final velocity, that is nothing but the v2. This value is unknown. Then acceleration, which is nothing but the tangential component along that path. So it is equal to 0.7 meter per second square. And the time span between the point 1 and 2, this is equal to 4 seconds. So you can use the equation to find out the v2. V is equal to u plus at. So v is nothing but the final velocity at point 2. U is the initial velocity, that is the 2, plus acceleration is 0.7 into t. So t is 4 seconds. So from this, you will get the answer. So this is 4.8 meter per second. So this is the velocity of the particle when it will reach to the point P2. Okay. Now at this point P2, its radius, it will remain same because this is a circular path. So it will be 4 meters. So you can find out the normal component of acceleration, An, this is equal to V2 square upon rho. So V2 is 4.8, this is square upon rho is 4 meters. So you will get the value An is equal to 5.76 meter per second square. Okay, so this is the normal component of the acceleration after 4 seconds, because after 4 seconds, particle will reach to the point P2. Now we have to find out the total acceleration. So total acceleration will be An square plus At square square root. So this is 5.76 square plus tangential component, it will remain constant at point 1 and at point 2. Okay. So that component is 0.7. So the resultant acceleration, this is equal to 5.802 meter per second square. Okay, so this is how you can find out the normal component and the tangential component of acceleration at point 2. Now to find out the distance traveled. Use the equation of motion. So this is the actual path traced by that particle. So initially particle is at the point 1. It reaches to point 2. So this will be the distance traveled. Okay. So along this path, we know the initial velocity. So this velocity is 2 meter per second. We know the acceleration, that is tangential component. So At is equal to, this is 0.7 meter per second square. Okay. So S is equal to Ut plus half At square. So initial velocity is 2 meter per second. Now time between 0.1 to 2, this is t is equal to 4 seconds. Okay, so solve this equation. So you will get the answer, s is equal to 13.6 meters. So this is the displacement or the distance traveled from 0.1 to 2. Okay, so in this problem, an airplane travels on a curved path. At point P, it has a speed of 360 kmph, that is a kilometer per hour, which is increasing at the rate 0.5 meter per second square. Determine at the point P, which is shown in the figure, first magnitude of the total acceleration, and second, the angle made by the acceleration vector with the x-axis. So this is the given diagram. Okay, so this is the path along which the airplane travels. And for this path, its equation y is equal to, this is 0.2 x square. Okay, so basically this is a parabola. And at particular point P, the speed of that airplane, so this point P, it is having the coordinates 4 and 3.2 in kilometer. And at this point P, the speed is 360 kilometer per hour. So if you draw one tangent line, it will represent its velocity. So this is equal to 360 kmph. Okay. And it is increasing at the rate 0.5 meter per second square. That means it has a tangential component of acceleration. So this component, it will act along the velocity. So this is nothing but the AT, and it is equal to 0.5 meter per second square. So what is to be determined? The magnitude of the total acceleration at the point P. Okay, so to find out this total acceleration, we need the tangential component, which is given in the problem directly, that is equal to 0.5 meter per second square. And we will need the normal component of acceleration. Okay, so normal component we have to find out at point P. So its formula is V square upon rho. Okay, so this rho value, if it is a circle, that means the curve is circle, then rho is equal to the radius. Okay. And if the curve is represented by some equation, y is equal to f of x, then the radius at a particular point on that curve, we can find out by using this equation. This is 1 plus dy by dx square bracket raised to 3 by 2 upon d2y upon dx2. Okay. So we need to find out these values dy by dx and d2y by dx2 at the given point P, which is 4 and 3.2. Okay. And then we can substitute this value in this equation and we can get the value of rho. So try to find out this dy by dx. So equation for that curve is y is equal to f of x, and that is equal to 0.2 x square. Okay. So differentiate this with respect to x. So we will get the dy by dx, that is equal to, this is 0.4 x, and again differentiate this equation. So we will get the second derivative. So this is d2y upon dx2 . So this derivative, this is equal to 0.4. okay, now we have to find out the exact value of the dy by dx and d2y by dx2 at the point 4 and 3.2.